Okay, I don't know when the video stopped, but I had a heck of a time getting that on there. We'll go in, try to go over it now. Maybe it was in the video and it stopped after but I just now realized the video had stopped. So I'm gonna put the two screws in. So used to all my drivers being magnetic that that's usually the best way to do it. Well, this is actually is a little bit magnetized. I noticed that, but not enough to hold one of those X's. I think I maybe be able to do it. Oh, that's not lining up. It used to be up higher. I need my scratch all. Maybe it'll pull it up. See if I can get this one in first. Then we'll do that one. Get it started anyway. Yeah, I think it's lining up. Those regular sockets don't actually grab. I don't think they maybe grab those kind of screws as well. Is this? Ah. Yeah, that seems to grab it better. They're more rounded off, I guess. You know, there's more to grab with the. They slip more, but this little deal here, this adapter, this is magnetized. This is aluminum, but there's a magnet down in there. But this falls off left and right. That's why I don't like to use it. Oh, look, it's staying. But. Anyway, I don't remember why I did that earlier today. And I go get my awl and try to line that up. Put a screwdriver under it on the ground. Same reason, yeah. There. I think that did it. Washer, you have to have something, things driven under it to get it to line up ever when you put the front back on in. Yeah, that's like so loose. There we go. Yeah, that grabs it a lot better than that regular socket. I guess the regular socket needs to go further over the nut head than you can go with those. They have a shoulder on them. Okay, yeah. Screwdriver out of there. All right, now. That's together, and let me check that, make sure it feels okay, then I'll spin it around and can't see it anymore. There's a flange that hides it, but it's spinning here. Of course, right now it's making no noise whatsoever. And it says in all the videos, what you know, if you just with common sense, you'd probably figure that out. But there's two lines there where that belt's been riding, but it says line your bolt up with your wear mark. You see, now that little plastic thing, that's really just for installation, I think, because now it's almost, it's like 3/4 to an inch away there. So, I can put the lid down. Oh yeah, I didn't vacuum, but I'll do that in a minute. I put the lid down. Oh yeah, it snaps down. It's actually going to be the best thing to do so that it won't be so cattywonkus. Let me put that fan back where it was and turn it on. Far enough away that it's not ruining the audio. It's been on for hours, so I'm not going to worry about it now. I'm sweating like a pig. It's a hot, humid night. It's been the hottest day I've been out in this year. I'm sure it was over 88. It was 88 when I came out, so I'm sure it got up to around... Could have stayed that. I don't know, but anyway. I didn't get miserable, though. Stayed out of the sun. Well, the wind was just blowing like crazy, so it helped a lot. Okay, I gotta spin it around. There's so many sharp edges on it. I'm not gonna spin it around without the brake. Because that would be a lot heavier now. I'll turn it around so I can get to it. Get to that cover and everything, and I had a screw in there, but what happens to, because this, I want this hanger on this cord to keep it from touching the vent pipe, because you know it gets hot. I'm afraid to get hot enough to melt it, so, but when you open this lid it breaks it out of there. So what I need to do is put it in. I looked, I didn't realize it was a step, but I was scared of putting it anywhere where I'd hit anything, like the drum or something. Of course, I could do a shorter screw, but maybe I'll do that. I think I had to have a longer screw, but anyway, we'll do that after we get that cover on and see if I really want to do that or not. I don't have to do it, but I've had it on there for years, and I like it. But it's not really staying there. It's all been pulled out from, as soon as you open that, it pulled it out, and it's been done that. What you need to do is unscrew it, and I didn't do that. But now you can see my handiwork. Let's see, whoa. Sorry. So you can't see anything really, but there's the quarter 20s, there's my grease. And there's those little sheet metal screws, and that's all you can see out of that. Not much to see. And down there, further, is where I put that wheel that I was greasing up and everything. I thought I was going to be taking it off, because sometimes it seems to tend to rattle. But with how quickly that plastic wears out. Now, if this metal one I put in there doesn't make noise, I'll probably leave it. Because it'll probably last for many years. But if it makes noise like I figure it will, well, of course I can grease it. So maybe if it makes noise, I grease it. And it, every, you know, if you only have to grease it every once in a while, it'll be all right. I can get the belt back on there. Okay. This would take a couple of 2 to 3 hours. It really did. That was a dumb idea. It's a dumb thing to think, wasn't it? Let's see. Oh, no. Not that loose. What have I done? I don't think it's broke. It came off. And sheet metal. Back on this came out. Turn it back around and hook it up. the door switch. It just hit me. It won't come on. I turn around to get to that. See if it rolls okay with the lid on first. Okay, it's rolling good. Now I'm gonna put the cover on. Well, I wanna see it roll. I wanna look at the belt one more time before I do that. And I wanna put this on. Maybe I'll see. Cover. Thank you. Okay, let's get it turned on. Too tired to redo that, so I just slipped that back in its hole. I think that's why I put that long screw in there. It'll hold it. Just is no pressure on it or anything. Too tired to redo that. Now I'm scared if I go, can't get it in there, and I'm scared if I go in there, I might actually be too low. I guess that's why I didn't do it. I should have drilled a hole from the outside or some inside out, so I know I'm not hitting anything like the drum or something, or the heating element area or something like that. Now the only other thing is turn it back around, plug it in, and hook up that drain, that exhaust, that has to hook up to the pipe that's going up there. I'm not gonna move the camera in for it anymore because it's just, I'm too tired. Okay, that's what a driver's supposed to sound like. Phew, now I got all the stuff to pick up. Better believe I'm done. Got it working. I don't know how long it takes that, you know, if that grease comes out of there and it starts squealing on the metal bracket I made, I put it in there on, but I know it's great. It's got to be in the bracket. I mean, I couldn't see if it was still in there, but it's got to be in there, I think. Or it wouldn't be rolling so smooth and everything. Okay. Well, I'm going to go and get a drink and clean my mess up here.